Welcome back, folks, for another tank review. Now today we're looking at the M36 Jackson. This is the most powerful tank destroyer made by the Americans during World War II. Now the Hellcat historically had the M1A2 76mm cannon. It never had the 90mm cannon like the Jackson. Also, the name Jackson was given to this tank destroyer by the British, like the Wolverine as well, also the Sherman. But American troops never really called the Jackson the Jackson. They just called it the tank destroyer. Same goes for the Wolverine. They never called it the Wolverine. They just called it tank destroyer. Whereas they actually liked the name Sherman for the M4 Sherman. So they actually called it the Sherman. But that's a key little fun fact, I guess. But this is the most powerful tank destroyer made by the Americans because of the 90mm gun. Now, within the game, this tank used the same gun as the Hellcat. So the Hellcat can mount the same 90mm gun. So damage-wise, these two tanks are pretty much the same. Same time reload time, same rate of fire, same DPM. So that's pretty much the same between these two tanks. Now, the main difference between the Jackson and the Hellcat is that the Jackson could carry more ammo. So this tank carries about 47 rounds, whereas the Hellcat could only carry 30 rounds. So more than 50% plus to the ammo ammunition loadout. So we carry more ammo for derping, I guess. Also, this tank has more armor than the Hellcat. The Hellcat has only 12mm of armor all the way around the tank, or tank destroyer hull, whereas the Jackson has 114mm on the lower plate, 71mm on the upper plate, and 25mm on the side and rear. So this tank has more armor at the front, but the turret is pretty much the same as the Hellcat turret. Now, it is not really 127mm of turret armor at the end or at the rear, so it's mostly this little triangle. So yeah, it's not that well armor of a turret, but in comparison between these two turrets, the Jackson's turret has the upper encasement or the metal sheet covering the top of the tank. So this tank takes less damage from HE shots from artillery, so that's a plus. But mostly this tank is slower than the Hellcat, so this is a fatter version of the Hellcat. Now, as always, you can click the battle button in the video so you can skip right to the action, but we're going to talk about the stats of this tank and how this tank is going to perform and whatnot. Now, the stock grind for the Jackson is pretty easy if you have fully upgraded the Hellcat. If you've done that, this tank already have the 90mm gun, so you can immediately install the 90mm gun without playing through the 76mm gun. So the only difference is that without the tracks, you cannot mount a gun rammer when playing with a 90mm gun. So the only thing you can mount is binoculars or camo nets. So you have to spend a few games playing through 7000 XP for the tracks in order to mount the gun rammer as well as the other equipment such as binoculars slash camo net. So that's alright. Top turret is also pretty much the same as the stock turret, so I leave it last. So the armor on the top turret is pretty much the same as the stock turret. Traverse speed is the same, view range is also the same, it weighs more, and it doesn't provide a rate of fire bonus for the 90mm gun. So the only reason to get this turret is for the HP as well as the space armor on the top of the turret. So the main difference between the Jackson and the Hellcat is that the turret has space armor at the top to prevent one shots from artillery, whereas the Hellcat doesn't have space armor at the top. So that's probably the main difference, as well as the armor. The Jackson has more armor at the front in comparison to the Hellcat. The turret is pretty much the same without the space armor. So the Jackson is a slower, fatter version of a Hellcat. So that's the main difference between the two tanks. Now, these two tanks use the same gun, so their roles are tank destroyer. So you couldn't play this tank more like a medium. You could, but it's not recommended. But here are the main stats for the Jackson. So this tank has 20 more HP than the Hellcat at 590. So that's still a decent amount of health. It's not a lot, but it's decent. So you have 20 more HP than the Hellcat. You weigh 10 tons more than the Hellcat, so you could ram light tanks or so, but don't go ramming heavy tanks, obviously. You have crappier engine than the Hellcat, by 40 horsepower. So this tank cannot shift as fast as the Hellcat. The top speed is 42 kilometers per hour, much slower in comparison to 72 kilometers per hour, obviously. Traverse is the same, 30 degrees per second, so that's quite all right. It has 114 millimeters of frontal lower plate armor. It's not the whole armor at the front. The top plate is only 71 millimeters, so that's misleading on Wargaming's part. So that's misleading on the armor of this tank. Side armor is 25 millimeters, which is crap. Rear armor is also 25 millimeters, so it's the same as the Wolverine's hull with upgraded upper plate. So this is the upgraded plate with 20 more millimeters of frontal upper plate. So that's pretty much it. Turret armor is 76 millimeters at the front. So it's pretty much the same as the Hellcat. It has a very good trollish mantlet, so like the Hellcat, 25 millimeters at the sides and 25 at the rear. So always stick the front of this tank towards your enemies. Always point this thing towards your enemies. The gun characteristics of the 90mm gun is pretty much the same as the Hellcat. So both tanks have the same DPM, 118, so that's pretty okay. Same dispersion, 0.35, same aim time, 1.7 seconds, so it's a tank destroyer obviously. Now this tank, since the 9.3 patch, has better gun characteristics on the move or with hull traverse and turret traverse than the Hellcat, because the Hellcat got nerfed during the 9.3 patch. But yeah, the gun characteristics is mostly the same. Now you can still play this tank like a tank destroyer slash medium tank, but generally you do not want to play this thing like a medium tank until later parts of the game, where most of the top tiers are wiped out and you're fighting lower tiers like tier 4s or 5s. So generally don't play this tank like a tank, like a medium tank, until most of the enemies are dead. So play tank destroyer first, then play medium tank. Now view range is very good, 370 meters, so you can easily wipe out other tanks with lower view range, because the KV-1S, or what am I talking about, KV-85, has about 330 meters of view range, so you can easily outclass Russian tanks with this view range. So let's look at the, I don't have the SU-100. Oh damn it. I sold my SU-100. I suck. Well, I had to have space for the SU-100 M1. Okay, let's see, SU-100. This thing has how much view range? 350 meters. So your meters of your view range is actually better than most other TDs at this tier. So use that to your advantage, obviously. Radio range is also decent, 650 meters. So actual radio range is also boosted by your crew, so that's pretty nice. Turret traverse is also slow, 16 degrees per second, so like the Hellcat, but you're not supposed to playing or brawling with this tank, so you should not play like a medium most of the time. That's pretty much it. Now, the equipment that I fitted is a gun rammer to increase the reload, obviously. Binoculars to increase the view range, up to 471 meters of view range, so you really need that. And camo nets to increase the camo rating on this tank, because it's still a tank destroyer with no armor whatsoever, in my opinion. So you still have to play sneaky with this tank. Now, crew skill is the same crew skills I have for most sneaky tank destroyers. Sixth sense for the commander, if you don't have it, have camo. So camo for everybody else. And the second skill for the commander is obviously camo, since I swapped it out for sixth sense. Snapshot for the gunner to increase the accuracy. Off-road driving for the driver to increase the mobility of this tank. Situational awareness for the radio operator to increase the view range. And repair slash safe stowage for the loader, but it doesn't really matter. So it's like the Hellcat, so pretty much the same as the Hellcat. But the main difference between the Jackson and the Hellcat is that this thing can carry more ammo. It carries 47 rounds, whereas the Hellcat carries only 30 rounds. So that's a more than 50% bonus in your ammunition loadout. Also, this tank is slower, so it has more armor than the Hellcat, but it's slower and carries more ammo. So it is like a fat Hellcat. Now let's go into Tank Inspector to look at the armor of this thing, and we'll play some live games afterwards. And here we have the M36 Jackson. So the armor on the front is misleading because the lower plate is 115 millimeters. The upper plate is about 60 millimeters. I thought it was 71. Oh well, that sucks. It's only 60 millimeters, whereas the Wolverine has about 50. Yep, it's only 10 millimeters. I thought it was 20 millimeters bonus, but I lied. It's only 60 millimeters. That's bummer. That sucks. Now you do have space armor at the sides, but they're mostly going to shoot the upper part of your side armor, which is only 25 millimeters. So side scraping with this tank is crap. So don't try to side scrape. That's a bad idea. Mantlet, however, is very trollish. So you might troll 122 millimeter guns from the Russians with this mantlet. But don't rely on it because it could easily be penetrated by the 76 millimeter M1A2 gun on the Wolverine, because I had Wolverines penetrating the mantlet. So it's trollish sometimes, but don't rely on it. So the turret is also crap, 25 millimeters. As well as the top of the tank is also crap. It's only space armor, but it's not even space armor. What am I talking about? Oh my god, it's not even space armor. That is bogus. So basically, let's look at the T25/2. Yeah, it's space armor on the top of the T25/2 because that's space armor. So you could troll shots by having your turret poke out while you're hull down and having people to shoot this space armor, and it doesn't affect the tank. Whereas if you have the Jackson, that thing is not space armor? I thought that was space armor. That is bogus. Oh no. This is actually part of the tank. And if you go hull down, if somebody shoots at this quote unquote space armor, you'll still get damaged. Unlike the T25/2. I was about to say Jackson, but that sucks. This is not space armor. I thought that was space armor. Oh my god. They're gonna eat this tank up. Oh no. Alright. So this tank has no armor other than a mantlet, as well as the lower plate. Now you do carry more ammo, but you're slower, so it's still a fat Hellcat. So play like the Hellcat, except just go slower to places, obviously. That's gonna suck. I thought that was space armor. Alright. DPM on this tank is not correct based on the game, obviously, but it's about 2085 with the gun rammer, so it's not 1800, so that's different. Now I'm gonna compare this directly with the Hellcat just to make sure. Now I want to see the main difference between the Hellcat and this tank. Oh yeah, they nerfed the DPM, so they didn't change the details within the game, so Wargaming still lies. But they did change the DPM onto tanks, so yep, DPM is different, obviously, by 122 damage per minute. Reload time is actually faster now. For some reason, it's still telling me that's 6.9 seconds on the Hellcat for some reason. I have no idea. I haven't played the Hellcat since the patch, so I don't know. But you do carry 17 more rounds, so that's pretty nice. Your range is the same. You have a crappier radio, but it does. 100 meters of radio is not that bad. Camo rating is very different, so you have way crappier camo rating, but it's still decent. 17% is about tier 7 light tank status, so it's not bad, but just not legendary like the Hellcat. Now, you do have better gun characteristics now after the patch in comparison to the Hellcat, so you can actually move and shoot in comparison to the Hellcat, so that's pretty nice. And gets into the same matchmaking. So it has better win rate than the Hellcat? Huh. Alright. You do have crappier engine as well as crappier specific power. So this tank doesn't shift as well, obviously. Traverse is the same. Forward speed is 30 less kilometers per hour. Reverse is 1 kilometers per hour less. But it has better traction on medium terrain than the Hellcat. So that's pretty nice. It's less brake force, so you cannot stop as fast as the Hellcat. Alright. Gun depression is also the same. 10 degrees of gun depression, very nice. 20 degrees of gun elevation, so that's pretty nice. So this thing is like a fat Hellcat. It reloads a little bit better, carries more ammo, but has less camo rating and moves slower. So, and I'm still kind of shocked that this is not space armor. I always thought this was space armor at the top, like the T25/2. which I already done a review about, but shooting at here will actually penetrate the tank and damage. That's gonna suck. So let's go back to the game and play some light games with the M36 Jackson. Now, I've been seal clubbing with this tank because I only play like 50 games and almost have 80% win rate. So you still have to play this thing like a tank destroyer. You still have to hide in the back and use your camera rating and your teammates to spot for you. So don't YOLO, never YOLO. That's a bad idea. But you do have a troll-ish gun mantlet as well as lower plate, so you might even bounce a few shots from a low caliber gun. So guns with like 120mm penetration might even bounce from your frontal upper plate or your lower plate or even your mantlet, but don't rely on it. So yeah. But alright, tier 6 game, 50% win rate mostly. Other good player is the type 58, so we have to squash him. Squash him and hear the lamentation of their women's. So in my opinion, this is not a bad tank, it's just fat Hellcat. Let's get this show on the road. It's basically a fat Hellcat, that's pretty much it. The engine sounds pretty nice though, so it goes So the engine sounds pretty nice, but it's not a bad looking tank. This is the most powerful tank destroyer made by the Americans during World War II. There's no such thing as the T-28 prototypes or T-28s or T-25AT or T-25/2, none of that crap. There's all blueprints. So this is the most powerful tank destroyer made by the Americans during World War II. I like that Wolverine. So it looks almost the same as a Wolverine. The hull is pretty much the same. Alright, we have a target. Penetration. Camo rating on this tank is not bad. 17%. Oh god, what the hell did that shot go? Okay, he died. I do have 6 cents now on this tank because the on track to the crew XP bonus stuff. So, alright. Bunch of Crusader Assault HE shell. So, you have good gun depression. Artillery. That was close. To me. Oh, destroy that Wolverine in an instant second. Alright, so artillery is looking this way. That sucks. Why is the Churchill not going to town? Huh. Now view range is still decent, 370 meters, so you can easily spot that Hellcat. Damn it! I hit the tracks, I didn't hit the hull. Now, in order to penetrate low targets or low armor targets with your HE, you must not shoot at the tracks. Otherwise, you will not penetrate and deal full damage. So you must penetrate and hit the hull armor or the weak armor instead of the tracks, because the tracks act like space armor. So that's the main reason why Jingles is pissed about not shooting with full damage on the HE shots. And the main reason is he hit the tracks. He didn't hit the weak hull armor. He hit the tracks and it did peanut damage. So don't shoot at tracks with your HE shots. Shoot at hull armors if you already know he has weak hull armor. So we have a few heavy tanks YOLOing to their base, and we'll just camp back here to see if their Jackson or their anybody else is wandering around. How the hell did we kill their Churchill? Oh, okay. We killed the Churchill 7. Alright. So, yep. Alright, everybody's cool. Made it into their base without being shot at. So that means nobody's watching this part of the map other than the Stug. So I'll pull up. There's the Stug B. Oh god dang it! Panzer 3-4. Tracked him! He might spot me from this range, but he's dead. So try to track with your shots if you can. Lead your shots that they hit the spool wheels or the drive wheels of the tanks. But it's pretty hard, so I'm not lying. It's pretty hard. Reload is pretty quick. 7 seconds. And he is out of here. Alright, we have enemy Jackson. You cannot shoot up the hill. We'll shoot this Excelsior if you can. Or we can pick off the best player on their team. So let's try to pick him off. Is he going to come back to help the team? Yeah, he's moved. Jackson, do you have a shot? Nope, he's dead. Their other tank destroyer, the bathtub. I call that thing the bathtub. That thing's gonna die pretty quickly. So we have to kill the Type 58 if we want to win this game, but we should be winning most of the time. So their heavy, slow, heavy tanks are not gonna get there in time. Oh, Jesus. Focus on not the artillery, Sonny Jim. Alright. Let's go kill the Type 58, but he has a better DPM than us, so we'll try to use the gun mallet to help bounce a few shots. But this is a pretty easy game. I didn't do squat. I didn't do jack squat. Okay, don't worry about that thing. Time to kill their best player! Ah, dang it. So, try to keep him off the cap circle while our team is capping. Let's see. Yeah, KV1S is dead. Come on, come on, come on. Don't let him get a defender medal. Kabow! Sup? Bye. And goodbye. Got their best player. I am awesome. Sam, you suck. But yeah, play like a tank destroyer. So you do have armor. What the hell? Enhanced gunling drive. From what? Oh, T110E3. Alright, sorry. Okay. But yeah. Okay, one premium day. Okay, nice juicy stuff. But that was a crap game in my opinion. That was so easy. The teammate or the enemy throw the game. Because they didn't send enough people on the northern flank. So they threw the game. I get some more pennies. Alright. Alright, let's have another. Thor likes another. Our tier 7. Alright. The newly reworked Miravanka. So no more magical forest. Wonderful. Wonderful. Let's drink. I have some margarita. And gonna drink some. Tasty. Alright, so tier 7. Mostly tier 6s. Actually all tier 6s. With a few tier 7s. Alright. So remember, this is Encounter, and you're still in a tank destroyer, so I'll tell you about few sneaky hidden places on this map now. I'll try, but there are a few more sneaky camp places on this map now. Let's go. So their best player is the Leopard, and we have to kill him. So Counter MVP. Counter MVP, Modern Warfare. Alright. So don't go into the magic forest because it's not a magic forest anymore. It doesn't provide you with any cover. None whatsoever. But, alright. Guys, it's an encounter. Hello? Apparently, damn it. Okay, the comet should mop up. He's not a bad player, so he should mop up. He should mop up, but I have a KV-85 with me with a 100mm gun. Alright, he should be accurate. I'll spot for him. But it looks like I need to be up on that hill. Dang it. So let's go into this hill. This map changed so much. I mean, like the top corners are, all the corners are now just empty no man's land. Where nobody been there before. I've never been there before. So weird map change. Alright, let's see, you have some cheeky shots. No, we don't. Damn it. No, no. Leopard. He's one of their best. He is the best player, so I'll be careful. his machine gun is gonna burst me. So you might be tempted to go after him, but you haven't spotted the rest of the team, so don't YOLO yet. He still have 3 minutes to cap, so that's a long time. And we have a BDR waiting, so don't YOLO, obviously. Be patient. Here is their VK, the douche wagon number 3, and SU-100. That hurts. We still haven't got spotted by him because of our view range, as well as our camo rating, so let's try to have a cheeky shot on this light tank. Okay, we're spotted. 6 cents OP. There is a Hummel in play, and we have to be careful, as well as a KV-2. That's another artillery, obviously. So our team should be moving up. The Comet is going for it. Now I just need to know where that KV-2 is. There he is. Alright, let's save the game. Now Mantlet still trolled the shots, but he didn't hit, obviously. Oh, we should have to save the game now, Tiger. Oh god! Oh! Okay, fine. Ah, damn it. Come on, team! So, I did my best, trying to reset, but I shot the Tiger while he was in the cap circle. So, yeah, don't go into Magic Forest on this map. It's Encounter, folks. It's the same as the Maravanka on not the rework. So it's still the same map. You don't go into the Magic Forest all the fucking team. But yeah. So the camera rating demonstrated by me is very good because I was able to shoot the SU-100 without him seeing me. So, and I didn't have a bush between him and me. So that's pretty crazy. Now, the main thing you want to learn from this battle is that don't go into the freaking Magic Forest when it's Encounter. It's fucking stupid. So just worry about the cap. I don't understand. I don't even know. But alright, that was a loss. So don't go into the Magic Forest because it's pointless, obviously. Pointless, but that was a crap game. Both games are crap. Jesus. But don't go into the Magic Forest. It's a bad idea. It's a dumb idea. Why would you go into the Magic Forest? It's an Encounter game. I should have been where that KV-85 was and sniped from the bushes, but oh well, too late, so sad. My gosh. So remember, don't go into the Magic Forest when it's Encounter. It's pointless. Obviously. Sean Connery says, obviously. Obviously, it's a bad idea. Obviously. Now shut down. Whenever he says sits, it sounds like shit. It's like shut down. Fucking Sean Connery. All right, Encounter again, and we're on Sand River. So remember, you're still a tank destroyer, and they have a very good IS-2 or a decent IS-2 player. And why the hell do I have 130 ping? The fudge sticks. Why so laggy for me? Is it recording? I have no idea, but guess I'll deal with it. So DPM on this tank is not bad. Camo rating is also not bad. Just remember, you're still a tank destroyer, so YOLOing is out of the options, obviously. But let's try to get this cheeky shot on this dude. Damn it, no shots. Get into position. Oh, good scouting by the KV-1. Cheeky! Okay. Now I shoot through the bush. Through the bush! So he might not have spotted me. He is behind a rock, never mind. You sneaky little bastard. So accuracy is not bad. And camera rating is also pretty decent. He didn't even see me. There we go, tracked him. And he's a sitting duck. There we go. You spend APCR on that thing? Yeah. What a waste. So, Stug, no shots. Crusader killed the T-34. Alright, we lost a buttload of tier 5 tanks, but that's alright. Dang it. Low. T-34. 1.7 second aim time is not bad. Accuracy is also very decent. Oh, that shit would hit if I actually didn't kill him. Or if somebody else didn't kill him. That's pretty cool. He's behind a rock. Dang it. Pull up. Pull up. I know you wanna. Pull up. Damn it. Alright, Tiger. Ooh. Don't hit your teammates, obviously. Ooh, that just flies over the top left corner. Top left corner. Don't pull back. Yeah, you bastard. Alright. That's about 500 meters away. That's pretty crazy. Alright, well, we'll keep camping this spot since there might be a comet, but he's going to deal with the SU-100Y, and that's going to be pretty painful. So the SU-100Y is going to camp that corner, never mind. IS-2. Booyah! Accuracy OP. And we have a chroma. I thought it was a comet. Best player in Nebula. Counter MVP! God damn it! leading shots is pretty goddamn hard. Oh! Oh, what? I thought I hit him! Freaking lags! I thought I hit him midair. That's so OP if it did. Oh, man. That's poo. Alright, Chroma's coming back for another round. What happened to the sound effect on that one? He obviously spots me from that range. There's a GW Panther and... There we go. Tracked him. He obviously spots me, and there's GW Panther. Alright, we'll finish him off pretty soon. Don't go into town. Do not go into town. God damn it. Freaking lead your shots, Sam. Lead your shots. Foxy. Okay, fine. I'm out. I'm sorry. I'll give up. I retreat. Now save the SU-100Y. It? Don't move, Esrondra. I can save you. Alright. Oh, that would be such an awesome shot if it hits. Come on, lags. Nice hit. Accuracy is still decent. So, the accuracy on this tank is still pretty, pretty good. Dang it! Missed. I get tunnel vision so hard of a tunnel vision. Okay, there's a Tiger and a GW Panther left. The Dracula. I love the Dracula. Going off a tangent again. Ready to fire. Damn it. Let's find another target. God dang it. So close. So damn close. Okay, Tiger. So lead your shots is pretty goddamn hard. Pretty goddamn hard. But we didn't even bounce a shot with our side armor. So that's even on the space armor. God dang it. There's a Tiger across this hill with a GW Panther. And I'll tell my Tiger that there's a shit somebody here. And he'll pop up and... There we are. He sees me. He obviously sees me. Tiger, take their shots. Tiger? Ready to fire. There we go, I'll spot him. Ah, okay. He's AFK. Fuck! Oh, good! Oh, I thought he was AFK. He's not, but I ammo racked him. I thought it was like, oh, shit. I'm sorry, your face got blown off. Okay, now use high explosive against the GW. Oh shit, he's all the way over there. But that was funny. I thought he was AFK. He's not. He points his gun towards me. I was like, oh shit. Alright, Let's kill the Dracula, and we'll be done with this game. So you want to aim the high explosive on the gun shield instead of the tracks. That's how you do full damage with high explosive shots. You do not want to aim your high explosive on the tracks, because the tracks acts like space armor. So that's why Jingles got pissed when he shoots at space armor, or shoots at the tracks of the RU, or the Ramatel Borsig. What the hell, the RU-251? No, he shoots the tracks of the Ramatel Borsig, and only does 100 damage, because he used high explosive on the tracks. Now if he shot the gun shield, that would deal full damage, but he didn't, so that's why he got pissed and said high explosive is not reliable. It is reliable if you do not shoot the tracks, obviously. So that's the main difference. But mastery match, or mastery badge, alright. That shot on the tiger was funny. I am racked him. 900 damage per Jesus. But I thought he was AFK. He wasn't. He surprised me. And I shot him. He exploded. Huh. Alright, one more game, then we're done. Alright. Assault, tier 6 game. So you have the camp. There is no artillery. Alright, let's use the view range to the max. Alright. But that was funny. I thought he was AFK. He's like, shoot the guy, he's AFK. The Cheeto's like, oh, shoot him, he's AFK. Nope, he's not AFK. He turns his fucking gun towards me. He's like, oh, shit. Alright, so the Jackson. Pretty decent of a tank destroyer, in my opinion. DPM is okay. Not as good as the Wolverine. Wolverine has 2,500 DPM, but the gun doesn't penetrate as well, obviously. But these two tanks are pretty much seal clubbers, because the ammo, you can carry 47 rounds. So you can spam the shots. Where, if you're playing the Hellcat, most of the time I have found trouble with the amount of ammunition on the Hellcat. So that's one of the main problems with the Hellcat, but not with this tank. This tank carries a lot more ammo, obviously, so you can derp more people. Alright, nobody's on this side of the map, so we have an easy 8. I'll tell him to fall back and not be derpy. So, I mean, don't judge other players, obviously. They're new to the game, obviously. So, you have to tell them sometimes what to do and what not to do. So, they might not have the brain of yours or your logic. So, you have to tell them stuff. So, give them time. So, be patient with your teammates, obviously. Don't be a dick. I like to be a dick, but don't be a dick. Still kills an M4. So, alright, we have a Hellcat. Dang it! Didn't leave that shot. So here's the high explosive. Do not aim at the tracks, though. Do not aim at the tracks! Damn it, aimed at the tracks, but it tracks off. That's alright. You can shoot at the middle of the hull. And that deal falls damage. Alright, Stug. Did I spot him, or did the Crusader did? I think the Crusader. That's a big cheeky shot. Now if he doesn't move, I'll kill him. He moved. So, yeah. Alright, M7 or M4. Sherman. Get this shot. Dang it! So, he spots me. Or somebody did. The Crusader. Taking to cover. EZA is going after the Crusader like a crazy madman. And we KS'd him. I'm a dick. Alright, Stug. Knock him out. There's a Panzer 3. I don't know if that hits, but it's gonna hurt as hell if it did. Alright, we're still gonna use our view range to our advantage. And our camera rating. So tell him to fall back. He'll provide a meat shield, or distraction at least. Alright. So view range on this tank is pretty good. There's a Nashorn camping. There's a Nashorn camping the ridge line. So, oh god damn it. Come on. There's a Wolverine. See, the lower plate throws me. He didn't even spot us? That's pretty nuts. I knew you are there, Sunny Jim. Even though you're behind a bush and I cannot see you. Okay, the Panzer III, obviously. And we're getting capped. Yep, he's gone. He's gone. Alright. Our Stug's cleaned up. And there's a Panzer III on the hill. And we'll go back to camping. There he is. See, view range, very OP! He sees us. He still haven't sawed us after that shot. So, we'll get rid of him. Hello. Now he sees us, but it's too late. Back to camping. That's how you play this tank. Use your view range, like the Hellcat. Now it could take a few more hits because you have 20 more HP as well as better armor. So it could take a few more hits. So use that to your advantage. Okay. Alright. Never mind. Goddamn armor trolls me! Goddamn Wolverine. The lower glacis is not bad. It just... You have to aim at the upper plate, donkey. Alright, let's. There's a Nashorn watching that corner, so don't YOLO just yet. God, you stop in the middle! Why do you do that? Dang it! Freaking lead the shot too much. He's just like, I thought he's gonna keep going. So, oh, you lose high explosive. These guys, really? You have to let me use the TP? Alright. I am your father! Alright. And need to cover. The Nashorn's on the hill behind us, so we are in cover. And pretty much game over. So let's try to get the top gun, if we can. But let's use a high explosive. So aim at gun shields, obviously. Always aim at gun shields with your high explosive. On artillery, on any light armor vehicles. Because you do not want to hit the tracks, and tracks are space armor. So, where the hell is that Nashorn? He has a decent camo rating, and very good view range, but we have 6 cents. And good crew. Just, I cannot spot him. Come on now, don't camp all day long. He has a very dangerous gun, obviously. Yep. Aha! Ha 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 ha! Oh, there you are!
Permission to engage.
You camping bastard.
Target released.
Have that. Okay. That's a high explosive shot. It will deal 320 damage, so he's one shot kill for me if I get the top gun. Now I have to have the steward. Okay. Come on. Ah! Dang it, motherfucker! That son of a gun! I got Top Gun stolen by a freaking... Who stole that kill? Who stole my kill? God damn it. Where the hell? Okay, where's that Nashorn? Valagirin. Who the hell is Valagirin? Fucking Stug KS by kill. God damn it. But easy high caliber, even though it's a low tier game. So you saw how easy you can camp and LC the Panzer III when it's driving down the little roadway. And you can easily shoot him once without him spotting you and shoot him again, then run back into cover. So yeah, but very. You need to use the tank because it's still a tank destroyer, so don't YOLO. Now, if I was to YOLO at the end with that Nashorn, I'll probably get like 2 or 3 hits into me, and I will probably die. So, 6 cents is very important on tank destroyers, obviously. But this is still a tank destroyer, so play cautiously with this tank. So don't YOLO. YOLO is a bad idea. If you YOLO, you're gonna die pretty quick. So, yeah, the Wolverine, the Jackson. But you saw how trollish the Wolverine armor was, and I bounce a shot off the lower plate as well as into the gun mantlet. So Wolverine is not a bad tank. This tank has the same chassis, so you still can't bounce a high caliber shot into your lower glazes, so that might bounce, but don't rely on it. So never rely on your armor. It has decent armor against high explosives, obviously, but always point your tank towards the front unless you know who's behind what bush and whatnot. But always use caution when playing tank destroyers. And I've been playing tank destroyers a lot. So okay, look at my statistics, but I play way more tank destroyers because I know how to camp. And camping is one of the best things you can do in this game because it's ambush. And ambush tactics are very fun because you just surprise somebody. It's like, surprise, motherfucker! So that's always fun. It's like, jump, motherfucker! I scares you. But yeah, the Wolverine, god damn, it's not the Wolverine, it's the Jackson. So the Jackson is not a bad tank. It's not. It's, in comparison to the Hellcat, it might be overshadowed or outclassed. But the Hellcat is decent. It got nerfed. So Jackson is still a viable choice. It has the same gun. Now history depicts this is the most powerful tank destroyer because of the 90mm gun. The Hellcat had the 76mm M1A2 gun. So, L gun. But yeah, this is still a decent tank, but just in comparison with the Hellcat, it's just in its shadow most of the time. But it's not a bad tank. I probably won't keep it, mostly because I don't play tier 6 that often. And if I do, I'll probably play the Cromwell, because the Cromwell is amazing. Or I'll probably play my Dickermax or my KB2. But Dickermax is also not a bad tank destroyer, since it has a very punchy gun. I also have the, what other tier 6 tanks I have that I could play? There we go, let's find out. So I have a buttload of other tier 6, like the Hellcat. I could just easily play the Hellcat, obviously. So I don't have to play the Jackson, but it's not a bad tank. I also could play the Box tank if I feel bored, or the Dicker Max, the Maximum Dick. So yeah, it's not a bad tank. If you would keep it, it's a very good seal clubbing tank. So it is very nice of a seal clubbing tank. 77% win rate, 78% win rate, doesn't matter, but it's still seal clubbing. Now armor wise, it's alright against low tiers like tier 4s or tier 5s, but it's not gonna hold up in a tier 8 game, obviously, so let alone a tier 6 game. But yeah, it's alright of an armor. And mobility is okay. It's not slow, it's not fast. It carries a lot of rounds, so it could derp a lot of shots. But generally people prefer the Hellcat, obviously, over this tank. So you can see why. The Hellcat is a lot faster, better camo rating, same gun, same DPM. Just a slight nerf now, obviously, but Jackson's not bad. But it's alright, fat Hellcat. Fat Hellcat. But thank you guys for watching, and I hope you guys enjoyed this review. I do a lot of tank reviews if people want it, but I also do leaked videos, such as my leaked info on 9.3 patch. That's kind of popular, but alright. I'll probably do more for the 9.4 as well as 9.5, as well as for the new EU tech tree, or the Italians, Hungarians, and Czechoslovakians. That's pretty cool. So yeah, I do a lot of stuff on my channel for World of Tanks, so if you enjoyed this video, think about subscribing to my channel, because I do a lot of World of Tanks stuff. But other than that, thank you guys for watching. Comment below on what you think about this tank or anything regarding to World of Tanks, and rate this video. Rate this video if you can. That will help me out. Okay, stop talking so fast. That will help me out a lot. But rate this video if you can. Comment below if you want, and I'll see you guys next time. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. I said that twice. I suck. I can't speak fast. But I'll see you guys next time. Peace.